and the interesting pick and ban phases of last game.
Fun ban being Trundle, and we'll see what blue team picks up with this. Kindred's left open. Once should be strong, but Hover's Draven.
Draven.
Not sure about the Draven. Let's go. That's
robotic 3000. Let's get on it.
I like a Draven. Hits
definitely
so hard.
Doesn't love a good Draven.
I wouldn't pick Zane as a Draven.
That I was expecting to see a Caitlyn pick, honestly.
Interesting.
Caitlyn's so strong right now.
You're just picking the losing lane at that point. Draven destroys Zane. But the Maokai is a good pick.
Oh, hang
on. Yep, there it is. Called it.
Is that Mind Reader Alex? I think so.
I just understand the meta, unlike somebody we know.
Savage.
God damn it. Lucian, please.
Lucian is probably the best ADC currently.
Yeah, so, definitely. It's either that or Caitlyn.
We all know Varus is the best ADC Kappa.
Man, that'd be stepping
to Varus. Jin? Somebody say Jin?
Jin's up there. He actually is. Yeah. I was looking at Luz yesterday.
Dude, Jin's so good. That's why I'm named after him.
The Maokai is a good pick, though. I'm liking it. It's a very strong top line, apparently. So after his small buff to his magic resist.
I like the Blitzcrank pick with Draven. If you're picking Blitz, you definitely need a high damage ADC. And Draven is just that.
Looking to get a lot of kills in that bot lane. Looking to get a lot of kills in general if they're blocking both these two.
Probably going to see a Morgana pick on purple team here with the Blitzcrank pick so early.
They should do.
Amumu does come out. We saw him last game. Put in mid lane, but gonna be putting jungle in his rightful place this time.
Was it locked in?
It wasn't locked in, but it was hovered over.
And it is big. It's a good choice.
Very strong jungler. If you can land your spears.
Looks like a Diana is being hovered over. Changed to a Fizz.
Looks like you're going to be wanting to be running the double TP, which put a lot of pressure onto the map. And from the looks of it, they still haven't swapped over from me. Double heal.
You're just clicking random.
Blue side. Not sure about the Yasuo. They got nothing to synergize with them.
You can get it off Maokai Q.
It's not a very big area though.
Yeah, it's really quick too.
Orianna would be good.
Yeah,
wouldn't be a bad pick.
That's some pretty good sieging. They still lack quite a bit of disengage. Engage, rather.
Yeah, Maokai's W, I think it is. Not a great range.
Especially considering they have good disengage. The Orianna roll. The Maokai.
Got a lot of poke,
sort of
too.
Stand there
with,
and lock everyone up.
Nid Q and the Orianna QW.
Blue side's really just kind of just trying to get up all on their face and just destroy them with a massive engage with the Blitzcrank and pick someone. Amumu has a massive CC and Syndra can follow up that CC with their own.
If this Blitz is good, he should dominate that bot lane.
The Akali pick.
Probably going to be full tank too.
It's strong. I'm not sure. It actually probably.
Oh,
Janna
is a terrible pick here.
Janna's not the best pick
such,
yet.
Yeah, such a squishy champion to go into a Blitzcrank Draven.
Would help a lot with their sieging though. They just have to get there.
I was more expecting an Alistar.
With their hard in the optimal pick.
With their hard engage, it'd be really good because they're out and they're just disengaging in general. Would
yeah,
help a lot.
Yeah, more than.
So she can survive early, I reckon that's a pretty good pick.
I mean, Blitzcrank can pull out of her ult, though. But I guess the knockback is still pretty
still
important.
Pretty good.
Use it for the knockback more than anything, really.
Let's see, she's gone Leona. That's good. Oh no, she's back to Janna.
I'm not against the Janna pick.
I don't like it. I don't know. I guess we'll see how it goes, but I don't like it.
She survives early. It should do alright.
Yeah, but it could have been a better pick, let's be honest here.
I would have went for Morgana, personally. If I was,
I mean, Morgana, I see where you're coming
from. You had the Black Shield.
I see where you're coming from, Nathan, but there were a lot of better picks that could have been chosen. Syndra has gone Flash Barrier.
It's a fairly squishy red side too, with only the Maokai being the actual tank. It's even an Alistair on bot side wouldn't have been too bad.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you have the knockback from your W and you can pulverize, or you become super tanky.
His ult would be real good for bot lane, considering how much damage they're gonna do.
Definitely. Alright.
Not sure about Syndra though. I don't think she does too well against Orianna.
Oh, Ahri swapped to TP just before.
Yeah. I'm interested to see this Akali Maokai match up in the top lane though.
See, I feel as if Maokai should win that sim because of the amount of AoE. If she goes invisible, he can just sort of use abilities and still hit her.
I mean, his ult's going to be huge against when she goes in a W.
They're kind of just looking to make picks, though, and just disengage. Especially with the near jungle. They don't have, like, any form of like, reliable engage, unless it's, like, a flash Maokai W into a Orianna ult.
I'm just ready for the combo.
They'll probably engage a fight. Meanwhile, also on the blue side, you have, like, you have the Blitzcrank hook, you have the Mumu Q ult. And you can follow that up with the Syndra, and you have this slow on Akali, and that you can just follow up with all the damage.
If this Syndra gets fed too, this Lucian's not gonna have a fun time with her just pressing.
Definitely not. I mean,
it's really strong.
Mumu will probably just want to be focusing onto their bot side, get this Draven huge, and just Lucian.
If the Draven gets that, it'll be massive. But I'm surprised the Kindred wasn't picked here.
Now on paper, the red side was actually the higher ranked team, so they could make it work.
I mean, we'll see what happens.
Mechanics alone, but we'll see.
If Syndra does get fed, purple team is going to have a tough time. Especially, well, most of their team are all squishy, 4 out of 5 members.
Not sure if I like the double TP. It would help them rotate quicker and allow them to siege more turrets easily. So it's actually not that bad. They really just look at the siege and play the objectives here.
Hit the 50-second delay mark. Counting down.
Syndra's just got barrier, interestingly.
Yeah, I said that.
Not heal, resource.
I mean, Orianna changed from exhaust to TP in the last few seconds.
Be interesting to see how this top matchup goes.
20 seconds.
Because Maokai should win that. He, with the amount of abilities Kali will be using, his passive will be doing heaps.
I feel like it's just going to be what they do with their TPs, though. Because that's just going to be a slap fest if Akali goes full tank.
Especially.
Their only worry should be their bot lane.
Alright, now we're in game. Alright, boys, let's see if Skins get wins this time.
Did the Skins get the wins last time? I can't.
The Skins did get the wins last time.
Damn.
No, did they?
Such a pay to win game.
Yeah, blue side did have the most skins, and then they did win the game, so... You're correct, Alex. Skins did get the wins.
Pay to win. This game's pay to win.
I knew it was rigged somehow.
Now, is it fair to say that the red side's Christchurch? I'm fairly sure it is.
Yeah, you're right, Nathan. Alright, now we got Snow Bunny Riven. Nidley.
Let's go.
Project Lucian, Forecast Janna. Best Dumplings hasn't connected yet. But it looks like Christchurch have won the skins game.
Let's see if the skins do get wins.
Let's see, Nathan. Now we're seeing 4 out of the 5 members of Christchurch were gold last season, where only one member of Kolbe is more silver.
As we get in, let's see who wins.
Finally again.
Is it this game get wins a red side? Or is it the blue team?
Carly bought 5 pots.
Ooh.
That's hypey, dude.
And a ruby crystal. Okay, I don't know. Sunfire?
She might be going straight Sunfire, yeah.
Yeah, Sunfire, Iceborne, Gauntlet. The typical tank build.
How to win games.
Oh, looks like
Makai's gone Doran's Ring instead of the
Corrupting Potion. Corrupting Potion.
Lose, I wonder if
he's gonna build tank. There's no way he's gonna build AP.
Nah, he's gonna build. Hopefully, build tank. He might build AP Bruiser.
This bot lane asks him by war, they may get a bit of poking.
A swift dodge by Draven.
Nothing should happen from this.
Ooh, Janna getting that slight amount of poke on.
Jungle is starting opposite side of the map, so they're probably going to end up opposite sides. So the blue side are really going to be trying to get this Draven going. Maybe it's just going to go through down to his bot.
Maokai setting up his little saplings. Looking for an early fight in Isakali.
If I was blue side, I would have started Golems as ADC. Draven's pretty easy to clear with, level 1.
We are probably going to look towards this bot lane to see who wins, because if whoever wins bot lane, we'll probably win this game.
Definitely. Pretty standard laning phase at the moment, nothing interesting happening. Nidalee looks like she's going straight for a red.
Bit of a trade going down top lane.
And mid lane as well. Syndra getting some damage onto the Orianna.
Looks like this literally could be coming to where.
She's running straight up.
Not gonna get a lot if it is pushed. No. She's going to evade, but there's nothing there.
Might be going for a dive? No. Not. The wolf spirit
could
is
be a dive. But
the wolf spirit is Zena. Yeah. No, she's leaving.
Syndra still getting that poke on the Orianna in mid lane.
Mm. Maybe still hasn't gotten his red, which is interesting. They should have just focused on that this Draven on bot lane. You should have gone to get this red, just went straight down, let the get Draven to their bot lane to push the wave in their, against them. So it goes back to their turret and it's just an easy gank from a Mumu to kill the Evolution.
Looks
jump.
Like it didn't go quite to plan then.
I just don't think they even realised that.
Yeah. A little bit of a scrap coming up top lane.
Big damage from the Q actually.
Oh, that mid lane dive. Oh yeah, it does have flash. She does have TP, so she might not lose too much out of it.
Syndrome
looks like
a Moom
is on his way top. The lane is pushed, so if he gets there now, he should be able to get a gank off. Don't think they're gonna kill him though.
He's gonna be seen by wards though.
I don't think that Marco's realized that.
Yeah, I think he was close. Too, like, close enough away from it.
Oh, here we go.
Yep.
Gank is coming up.
Q hit.
He's flash.
It's my first blood.
Does flash. Didn't even burn the flash. Bit of a waste of time.
Just confidently strutted away. I just health bot, and that was basically it.
Strong in the bent tree that needs no ganks.
Of course he is, look at him. Huge. Bot lane's backed.
There is a slight CS lead in the jungle and the mid lane, Garen.
And the bot lane as well.
I mean, we really should be looking to gank the Orianna here when she saw his flash burned. Look how far the lane pushed.
Scrap is on bot lane. Blitz did miss his hook.
TP.
Yeah, blue side net eye.
Akali. Yeah, Akali still has hers.
Now both mid lane and top lane have hit 6.
Top lane does have the item advantage with that Doran's ring, but it's not big.
Probably yeah, I don't think that's going to be enough, honestly.
No, definitely not.
However, both mid laners seem to be opting to build towards that challenge.
Here we go. A fight in top lane.
There is 3 bot, they're looking for that gank bot.
Carly still fighting this Maokai, but Maokai does win that trade.
Don't see it.
Nidalee is lurking here, she hasn't been sane. But doesn't gonna get anything out of it.
Yeah, blew out a ward on that bush, so...
Good thing she didn't overstay and waste her time.
Mumu looking to go top again, maybe? Gonna walk through a ward though.
Yep.
Yep. He's been pinged back.
Marco
taking him,
taking
doesn't,
that CS.
Doesn't bad.
It's gonna cost him.
Q misses.
He's lost in the flash.
TP does come
TP's
in.
TP's coming out from Orianna. This might be good for red side here.
Oh.
Nice ult.
Good ult, but
they just don't have the damage.
TP with no mana.
Yeah, zero mana. Flash comes out from Mumu.
And Sinju's heading up.
Both just gonna walk it out. Yeah, I don't think Sinju's gonna get there on time.
She lost quite a bit for that.
Yeah, she wasted TP and ult. I mean,
just TPing without mana. Pretty silly.
Probably not the smartest play.
Yeah.
Sindhu does take a walk up there just to see if they're still there. But no luck.
Sindhu now has that increase that CS lead by quite a bit. She did follow, so she missed out a bit. But the CS lead in jungle is huge. That Nidalee has so much more CS and Mumu, which could lead to
Mumu's been
devastating. Nidalee's opted to farm instead of gank.
She has 900 more gold than the Mumu.
He's been more ganking than anything, more ganking than CS.
level 7 to his level 5, just about to hit level 6, I'm pretty sure.
Nidalee did get the deep wards in the jungle.
Mid gank.
Oh, Nidalee gank is going mid.
Hits the Q. Oh. Jesus.
Oh.
Oh.
That would have been a kill.
Just misses the Q.
Hit the spear.
Ariana was a bit too late to react to that gank for some reason.
She's going back to farm.
Pings are going down on bottom lane. Looks like they're setting up for something. Oh. Nidalee started dragging. It's 4 on bot side. Mumu's top side. This should be a free drag. Yep. Red side take the first dragon. Fairly easily.
It's a pretty risky dragon. They didn't have any vision on the Mumu.
I guess they would have known Syndra backed.
It also did have the deep ward, so they would have even seen him.
Yeah, if they'd walked for that way. Pretty good ward coverage on bot side by red. Mm. Barely any ward on the map anywhere for blue.
I don't think there's a single one. Oh, they just placed one mid.
It was an easy drag. Because they had wards on the red buff, and behind the red buff. So they knew Mumu wasn't around.
They've managed to increase the gold lead at 2k.
Ari's gonna die.
Man, that's
first blood. That's gonna be really good on the Syndra too.
If you got 4 man
the ult does come out for Lucian.
Lucian just walks it out though. Bit of a waste of TP right there.
But they're burning the flash on the Jhan and the exhaust. But they don't get
Maokai's just gonna get. Yeah. Maokai's just gonna punish.
Get a few damage
bit of damage.
Arrow.
And Akali's gonna miss a lot of CS. Like 2 waves probably.
Malco is going to get a lot of damage on that
still
tower.
Still trying to get this bot lane. They really want to dive this.
Oh, Akali should not still be here.
Jhana still has
Nidalee's,
ult.
Nidalee's running down too. Things are going down on the bush. Mumu's just going to walk out.
Malco looking to take that top tower. But he needs another wave for that.
Blue side didn't really get anything out of that. Gold lead was
that was a bit of a waste of TP right there. She missed. Akali missed like 3 waves and he's gonna get this tower, I'm pretty sure.
Mm.
Yep.
Syndra did get out of kill though, so if they play around her, they might be able to snowball that.
That's a tower at 11 minutes there. Easy tower. There was no real pressure top lane to stop that.
Mayo should just try roaming mid now to try and counter that first blood Syndra got. See what he does when he backs. Oh, Mumu's coming top. Oh, is he doing Scuttle? Yeah, he's doing Scuttle.
Gonna be met by Nidalee then.
Yeah, Nidalee's just gonna walk up on him.
Oh.
Maokai's on his way and Mumu just used Q.
Kali's
that's a lot of damage coming up.
Doesn't have flash. This is gonna be a kill. Looks like. He lands a Q. Oh, misses it. Syndra's gonna be there. Flash wasted by Nidalee. Oh, nice flash by Nidalee. Still gonna go down to Akali.
Oh, they'll do
nice Orianna. Got both of them. Oh, seems they lost track of Akali. Yeah, invisible.
And that was a 2-for-1 trade for the blue team. Red team, sorry.
Syndra still does have that gold lead in the mid lane, but Nidalee is a K and a 1.3 K ahead in the jungle.
They're gonna get some damage done on this tower too.
Yeah.
Still no wards from blue side.
I'm very surprised at that.
I really need to be warding that river just to.
Akali, Amuna, and Syndra are coming up through the mid lane. They're looking to stop this push from the Orianna and Malka.
Ratchet is back off there. They don't know what else is there.
Malka looks like he's about to rotate top again.
Gonna get that top wave on his tower. The Blitzcrank Drave in the lane didn't really get much from their early damage either, which is rare. They pretty much shine because of Draven's Q.
Mmm, definitely.
And now this Jhana is going to become quite big because of the disengage she has. Red Draven, side, all they have to do is just poke and siege and disengage with Jhana.
Draven should have a fair few stacks too on his passive.
If you play,
he's going to be one to be cashing in. If
you play Blitzcrank bot, you need to apply some early pressure, especially with his Q. Nidalee just, you know, absolutely destroying this movement in CS. She's level 10 to her. That movement's level 7. Pretty quiet across the map at the moment. Kali looking to take cover.
Kali's gonna meet Nidalee. This is the Q, that's gonna be it. Looks like they're gonna. No, Kali's just gonna jump the wall. I mean, Nidalee, sorry.
Narkar still pushing that top lane.
Nidalee is around bot, so they could get a gank on this bot lane.
There are no wards from the blue side still.
Looks like Maokai's heading mid. Might be able to get something here to send
to the
wall. Here we go, the flash does come out.
Oh, flash comes out.
A good ult from Orianna here.
Knock up. And Nidalee takes it with the Q. That's gonna be a tower.
Didn't have flash there.
I'm moving over to Kali. Ah, there. No, it's gonna be a tower.
That's tower for red team. That's second tower in 15 minutes.
Maokai played that correctly, coming down after he got top tower. He's going to be putting a lot of pressure on the map, and it looks like Red are going to go for take the second dragon.
Definitely. They've got wards around there. Still not a heap load of wards.
Blue don't have wards on this. This is just going to be free once again. Moom is nowhere near.
Not much blue side to do against this.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh, Draven nearly.
Draven with a... Oh, the pull.
Oh, nice pull by Blitzcrank. Oh, heal comes out. Oh, Moomoo, giant.
Nice.
Beautiful ult. Beautiful ult.
That was a fantastic ult.
Amumu would have been right in there with his ult.
Janna MVP that fight.
Yeah.
That was definitely a great fight.
Maokai's walking up too. Sitting on a ward though. Yeah, he's leaving.
They do have, the red side do have a lot of wards in this bot side jungle. Just following, knowing just exactly where Amumu is.
Maybe he's looking to clear him now. Sadly, he ran out of time on his buff. Maokai looking to stroll top again and start to push it out. Oh no, he's gonna hover around mid.
The wave is kind of frozen top.
Yeah.
So, unless someone goes to clear it.
I mean, just he could have pushed it, but he's gonna hold mid for this Orianna instead.
Draven just finished his Infinity Edge. He's gonna be quite strong now.
Lusa just, I don't think, have committed enough to this Draven pick. They picked Draven in hopes that they get killed.
Yeah.
Just, I don't think there was a single move against bot lane. And there's just no wards around bot lane to keep this man safe. It's just, they could easily get dived. There's just nothing they'll can do about it.
Once again, in both games, we're seeing a huge presence from the junglers. Nidalee has got a lot of ages.
Looks like they're gonna go for a 4-man bot. Mayo's backing. Does have TP.
Looks like they're trying to get the tower.
Akali's TP is up, so if they go for the dive here. It'll be
Orianna and Nidalee splitting up with the back.
They haven't been seen.
Yeah, they are gonna be. Johnny gets pulled here.
That was a good ult.
Nice ult once again. Draven's stranded. Blitzcrank's just not winning.
Orianna ult does come out.
Nice flash. Should be out. Yeah, he's out.
I'm not sure what Amumu or just the blue side in general are doing. They picked the Draven.
Amumu's a bit too slow.
They haven't done anything with it.
No care on it.
Oh,
Syndra walks right into a Nidalee Q. She should be able to finish it here.
The barrier will come.
Doesn't
out.
Know about Amumu though. Oh, he just.
Looks like we'll pick up the double anyway.
Yeah, that's gonna be Amumu dead too.
It's gold
double
lead.
Kill
it's
on
gold
Nidalee.
6K, yeah.
It's a huge gold lead. They're looking for second tier turret. Ooh, as well. Oh, no.
Just misses that Q.
Red's on that, grouping it up, pushing it in. It should be nice and easy for them with their sieging potential.
Yeah, this is an easy mid tower here. No one's there to defend it.
No, Draven and Akali can't do much to stop this.
Looking for bot turrets.
For Herald. Yep, they should just take that red, go to bot side.
Blue side are just losing things all over the map currently. And they don't even know about it, they got no wards.
This is a nice play by Red Team, yeah. They're really capitalized on their lead. Should be another
really
free tower here. I don't think
Blue.
Yep, Blue did not get there on time once again.
They're just a few seconds slow on just every single play red side, mate.
I'm really loving these rotations from the red side. Straight from mid, straight down to bot. Getting those towers, textbook.
Blue side really just want to be trying to reclaim all their vision currently. They have not a single ward on the map. All they're doing is clearing the red ones. They're not gaining anything.
It's definitely cost them. There's so many times where just a simple ward could have stopped Fs.
They just can't see the rotations that
result. Yeah, they don't understand just, what's happening until it actually happens.
That's why they're slow.
Vision's key in this game.
Blue side are pinging Baron.
Might be a desperation Baron.
A desperation
Red
Baron.
Sides don't have any wards on it.
Wards on it. Nidalee's back. Yeah, it's just checking it.
I mean, it would be very, very risky.
Jana's about to walk into. Ooh. Almost.
Just looking at Syndra, she's very squishy.
Looks Frank still doesn't have flash, so they don't have to worry about a flash shot.
This Blitzcrank's not been really present in the game.
Nah, definitely not.
This bot lane at all, honestly. Zero kill participation. Didn't even see a fight go down, which is really what they should be hoping for early. No ganks, like you said.
Nidalee's had pressure. But that was only for top and mid. Lucian will reset his red buff. Maokai is just shoving that top tower.
Looking to get the dragon third dragon.
Just
yeah, just as it spawns. No one can deal free a topside once again. No wards, no dragon whatsoever.
Like a third drag for the red team.
It's like either they just didn't want to contest it or that, or they just didn't even have the time. It's just better to just spawn.
I feel like it was the second option. Just due for the lack of wards.
Bot turret.
Blue side are just so far pushed in right now. They can't even like get out of their base to ward.
Oh,
they haven't even upgraded the blue trinkets, which
miss pull from blitz.
Once again, they help a lot.
Oh, blitz looking to land a pull.
Just miss every time.
Never lucky.
Reds are just controlling the pace of this game. Just where and when they wanna just try to fight.
Draven's backing in.
Not
see
sure
that. They
backing.
Should know.
That was a good stun.
I stun up. No, nothing to do with it though.
Blitz misses for once again. Just short. Good stun again from Syndra.
Ariana's left.
She's looking to shove that mid.
Blue side will see this. They should try to force a fight here.
Blitzcrank. Amumu should just be charging forward to try and get onto the Lucian.
They all have flash, so they could have just flashed forward.
Oh, that's a nice stun.
Especially with that, but
nothing off it.
Not doing it.
All they have to do is walk forward and maybe can absolutely ruin these
guys. Ryan is pushed into their tower now, so they're gonna have to send someone to that. Or they can just all rotate to it.
They all rotate, they're gonna lose that bot tower. Oh, good pull from Blitz. The flash
don't
does
think
come
gonna
out
get a lot of it though, yeah. Lucian ult.
The Lucian nerf. Let's go.
Just constant pressure from red team right now.
They
Blue just cannot handle it at all.
Nid and Orianna looking to rotate mid lane. While Lucian, Shadow, and Maokai keep that pressure bot.
Parrots are just slowly going down.
You know what, say slow and steady wins the race.
It should be turret.
Yeah, that should be tower down unless we want to do anything about it. Doesn't look like it.
They really should just be trying to force a fight here. There's five of them here, yeah. Around mid.
They're all full health too.
Come on, Blue Team, let's go.
They have all flash. They have
let's summons. Engage, Blue Team. Orianna looking to take that mid lane tower.
Now they're looking for something when they're gonna lose. Yeah, they're gonna lose the tower off it. Possibly.
Orianna sadly couldn't take that mid.
Carly's gonna go stop that. But Red can now just
nice
push on bot.
Just they don't seem to know how to communicate.
Typical lose-lose situation for Blue Team here.
Orianna's got TP, that's why she's running around the map, pushing waves in.
Oh, good pull from Blitz.
Yeah, that was a nice pull. Cinder just misses.
Red side should back up.
Yeah, that. Blue Team should look to fight here. Orianna's all the way up there, not gonna really get much off that wave pushing. Does have TP, but
kinda just need to commit to these players.
They've landed some good Syndra pulls, which should really have an Amumu follow up, but nothing there.
Like, the stuns have been going down, and Blitz occasionally is hitting his pulls, which is allowing this team to drop to low HP. Once again, landed short with the pull.
They should be trying for this fight right now. They see Nidalee, they see Orianna.
It's now a 3v4. Draven.
Could be a pick on Janna.
Nice Syndra, nice Syndra stun.
Flash does come out.
Flashes. Don't think they're gonna catch this either. Nope.
Nidalee looking to push
maybe
that mid tower.
Maybe it's just not doing anything in this game, really.
Nidalee gonna rotate up top, and they should secure that top tower.
Yeah, that's gonna be top tower gone.
Very low kill game.
Yep. It's just been about the objectives in this one.
Red side is just rotating significantly better with just the blue side just don't have any wards. They just don't even see it.
Things for Dragon coming up again.
That will go down.
Blue side should really invest in grabbing blue trinkets here. If they can't leave their base,
they need
to ward from
pink
deep.
Wars. They just need to start, like, picking up their jungle, game fish.
The three wards that Blitz is going to give them, it's not enough.
They don't even get placed, dude. The dragon that was wasted, so there won't be any attempted steal on the dragon here.
Nidalee just starving of their camps. Oh, it's a big damage from the mid.
All blue side's key ults are up, so they could do something here if they group properly.
They see them all down there, but they just don't understand they're gonna go for a dragon. Apparently. Moon's looking for his golems.
This one will be pretty big too, it's gonna be the turret resistance.
They're just gonna give it. Oh, are they gonna go rush for a baron?
They have no.
They don't have, I don't think they have
no
the damage
wards.
For it.
They don't have.
No, nope, they're just pushing mid.
That's fourth dragon for the red team.
Okay. They saw four people down there, but apparently no one fought. What are they gonna go for here?
They're just not trying to trade it with anything.
stun coming up Nidalee. Nidalee syndrome.
Blitz is walking up, looking for a pull, misses.
Misses it. Another Q from Nidalee. Wards now on both teams lacking. But
at this point, Red Tide just have control of the map. Yeah. They're all too far ahead.
They've absolutely they've taken that jungle, that Amumu's jungle. Still so far behind in CS.
Two levels up on him. Nidalee's two levels up on him too. Amumu's behind her if they land something. Amumu
should have gone in then.
Oh,
yeah, oh, no. He should go in now. He's just not too scared for it.
They see Orianna top, Maokai bot. Are they scared of the TPs? Probably scared of the TPs.
I feel like
they're such
are.
A bursty team, though. I feel like they can kill one player off the Amumu ult.
Yeah, even before.
Like this. This should be a dead Janna right here.
Syndrome is dead stun.
And Blitzcrank missed his pull as well.
Nah, he landed it.
Oh, sorry, not Blitzcrank. Amumu missed his bandaged us.
Yeah, it's
oh, the pull does come out.
This should be the fire. Orianna's
they're
not
focusing
yet.
Too much on.
Amumu doesn't.
Maokai is huge tree.
Kali's in the backline. Nice ult by Draven. It's gonna do a lot of damage.
Oh, yeah,
Kali flash ult.
Another good pull from Blitz.
Blitzcrank's still alive.
This could be game.
Lucian does come out.
Oof.
And that should be an easy in here.
Maokai stayed alive for so long in five players right there. Oh, look what he's
Lucian
got. Lucian
just has no damage.
Look what he has.
Nathan did call it Sunfire Iceborne. And they're looking to get all three towers and inhibs if they can.
Draven just cannot stop this right now. I don't think he can fight anyone. It's gonna be free. Yep.
There's a
looking like
free
inhibs.
Free inhibs. And that's actually gonna absolutely punish the blue team here.
Now hard thing to come back from.
It's a matter of time at this point.
Now, either red team can just go for one last final push and win, or they can just go for Baron and win.
Yeah, they can just bait up Baron, force them out if they're going to contest it.
Do a
Baron,
little Baron dance.
Walk in, done. But yeah, if they Baron dance, blue side lose. Mm. Super
they can't afford to, like, blue can't afford to do much here.
If they want to come back from this, they really need really. Like, good decisive calls.
They'll have to wait it out though, they can't Baron dance.
They've currently just been doing, like, half of them doing one thing, the other half doing the other.
Just look at Red Team's trinkets, the pinks, they're all over the vision control. And then you look at Blue side, they've all still got yellow trinket wads. But you
except
barely see any of them out on the map in places where you need them.
And it looks to me like Red Team are going to secure this Baron quite quickly.
Blue have no idea.
No vision whatsoever.
Now she just missed easy 5 walk mid. And
just a simple blue trinket could have helped them so much in this game. Because it's been hard for them to leave base.
Mm.
But
that blue trinket
water
from the same rotation.
It looks like the siege is just going to
Yeah, they're
out.
Just going to run down it.
And this is just game.
Just going to be game.
Draven gets annihilated. Akali's trying to get on the Lucian, doesn't happen.
Janna goes for a flash.
Nice little flash there, but.
And that looks to be game.
That's going to be game. Destruction all round, really. Just pure outplay from Red Side. They were just all over vision control, all over map control.
Christchurch played that game.
Everything.
Really well. I'll give them that. They played very conservative early game, and then they just popped off late game.
Simply off the team comp, if they played it properly, Blue Side should have just won. It's like
it was lack of vision.
That, and it's just like, fine, you pick the Draven. Draven has to get rolling early, right? You can't just have Draven be useless in lane.
It
they
was just
try
a
to
lack
fight
of
in
games.
Lane. They didn't commit to anything to
Draven. They pick a Blitzcrank too. A Blitzcrank Draven Lane, such a strong early game. The amount of damage they do is ridiculous. And
did nothing.
What did we see? Game. We saw nothing.
Like, they got heaps of good Syndra
in all fairness,
and
both
then
of
there
the
was
junglers,
just no follow-up.
Both of the junglers in both teams didn't even touch bot remotely that much. But the junglers still had pressure in other lanes.
It's just a whole lot of mistakes from those sides. Costum just kept losing because there was not a lot of deaths that game.
No. Yeah, it was really just an objective map control.
It was 2-6
game.
At 25 minutes. Yeah. And they just didn't have any wards. They couldn't see the red side getting all the
They just couldn't do a thing about what they were doing.
They were a few seconds behind because they had no wards. It's like, they were just behind.
Yeah.
Like, they had to fight early to get this Draven going. They should have committed Amumu more bot lane. They just
Amumu just didn't do anything really that game at all.
Maybe a different top lane instead of
He tried to gank top lane too much.
Maybe a different top lane instead of Kali with probably one more CC.
Yeah.
Might have been a bit better.
But Malkai was living for five people.
It was so huge.
Yeah, that Malkai was huge.
His build, the classic tank top build.
Good game to both teams.
Yeah. Well played by both teams. All four teams tonight.
Yeah.
And
Christchurch and
Kolbe College.
Baldura.
Kolbe Catholic College.
Head on into the winner's bracket whilst these other two go through the loser bracket in hopes that they can get back. So I'm Nathan with Alex and Jesse, and we're off.
Bye.
See you guys.
Bye.
So everyone, that wraps up the matchups for tonight. We would like to thank Nathan, Alex, and Jesse again. They've done an incredible job commentating for these matches. Yes, they are tight, and sometimes they might fall into a little bit of a snowball type effect, but we have four great teams who will be able to be hitting the games again in the losers brackets and winners brackets rounds. But for next week, we have round one. And we still have basically four more teams left. We have Tranby College, Aquinas, Penrose, and we have Ross Moyne Senior High School as well. So we look forward to those. Besides that, on 14th of May, we'd like to announce that we are hosting an event that is looking to crowdfund and raise some money for our fantastic charity Headspace. You will hear more about that on the website, flaktest.com. Stay tuned. We'll be sending out newsletters to all the registered members. And if you have not registered yet, hop on to flaktest.com and sign up now via the player registration. Or if you are interested in staffing as well for the tournament, please sign up under staff registration. I'm Brett Sullivan. We are Flaktest Gaming, and we are so happy that this went so well. And we'd like to wish you all a safe and enjoyable weekend. I'll see you next week. Bye. We'll be right back.